Hey everyone, Luke Dog here, and welcome back to Assassin's Creed Brotherhood. First off, yes, I took a few days off for my cold, and while I'm still not 100%, I got like a sore throat now from the coughing, I believe the worst is behind me, so I'm gonna try and get back to recording and posting videos. Second, I actually tried recording not too long ago. I thought it was recording, it said I was recording, but I had absolutely no footage or audio. Hence why I'm in this menu. Because if you can see, I did part of sequence 2. However, I have no footage for it. So I'm gonna have to redo it. So, welcome to Rome. Again. Luckily, it shouldn't take that long, though. We might miss a few cutscenes, but that's what happens, unfortunately. Eh, maybe not.
Calmatevi. The pain will end soon.
Where have you brought me?
Nowhere, Messere. A man left you here.
Did he say anything?
Only this. You are to meet Messer Machiavelli in front of the Mausoleo di Augusto. Let me help you get dressed.
The same man who brought me here gave me these clothes?
Si, Messere.
Roma.
Yes, or what is left of it since the Borgia came to power.
And the Mausoleo?
Unfortunately, you cannot see it from here.
How about from the top of that church?
Yes, but the stairs up are closed.
That should not be a problem. Vi ringrazio di tutto quello che avete fatto per me, buona donna. Addio.
Welcome to optional synchronization things. Also, we get to read all these again. Well, you're seeing them for the first time. I get to read them again. Mura Aurelian. Enclosing all the seven hills of Rome, this line of city walls was built during the reigns of Emperor Aurelian and Emperor Probus from 271 to 275. It served as a deterrent against raiding clans of barbarians who liked to strike poorly defended suburbs and villages. In 545, during the Gothic War, Totila, king of the Ostrogoths, destroyed much of the walls in an attempt to reduce the Byzantines' ability to defend the city. And that's what's wrong with Goths today. Too much makeup, not enough village raising. Evidence suggests a human presence in the area of Rome for at least 10,000 years. The mythology of early Rome tells us that the city was founded by Romulus, who was raised in a cave with his brother Remus, by a she-wolf. Apparently, the two infant boys took their nourishment from her teat. A story like that must be true, right? Archaeological evidence supports that Rome did in fact grow from pastoral settlements on Colli Palatino, the future site of the Roman Forum, upon which there are several caves. Eventually, the Republic of Rome was founded in circa 510 BCE. The successful and wealthy Republic gave birth to the Imperial Roman Empires, circa 27 BCE, which were sprawling territories ruled by succeeding emperors. When the empire fell in 476 and the Roman Catholic Church took power in 756, Rome continued to be both an economic and cultural powerhouse in Europe. In the mid-14th century, Florence surpassed Rome as the epicenter of the Italian Renaissance. This irked the papacy to no end, so they set about spending vast amounts of money and resources, commissioning architects and artists to create masterworks in an effort to bring the focus back to Rome. The result of this vanity-driven ambition was an unmatched creative and scientific output that is still marveled over today. It's safe to say that Rome is historically one of the most important cities in Western history, and arguably the world. Porta Semiana. In the Middle Ages, the Via Recta left through this gate leading to the Tiveri, Tiber River, port in Trastevere. It was restored at the beginning of the 15th century and again in 1498 when Pope Alexander VI wanted to give it a more military feel, right before Cesare marched out of the Vatican to attack Romagna in the Villa Auditore.
I need to find the doctor.
Yes, you do. So yeah, I literally went through all this like less than a half an hour ago. So I apologize if I don't remember exactly what I was talking about or saying when.
Ah, my arm.
Aqua Virgine. Named partially for the virgin waters that flow through its channels in a myth that 30 Roman soldiers asking for water were led by a beautiful young girl to the source springs. How they knew she was a virgin is pretty self-evident. The Aqua Virgine is the most famous water source in Rome. Its springs provide the Trevi Fountain, the Villa Borghese, the north and south fountains of the Piazza Navona, and the fountains of the Piazza del Popolo with their water, none of which you will get to see because they were all built in the mid-16th century. Considered to be some of the best drinking water in the world, Romans and visitors line up to fill containers from the fountains. Although after a 2007 construction accident that halted the Virgine's flow temporarily, and the chemical cocktail distilled daily in the Trevi Fountain to keep it clean, I'd stick to tea. That's probably a good idea. Diagrams of the human body and the printing press influenced Renaissance medicine greatly, which had in turn been influenced by Arabic medicine during the Middle Ages. By the 15th century, science had already begun a slow climb toward becoming more relevant than spirituality in the field of healthcare. However, many people stubbornly clung to old ways, visiting local mystics instead of doctors. After the plague ravaged Europe in 1350, many doctors dressed in special plague gear to treat patients. To prevent contamination, they wore a cape coated in wax and a primitive gas mask in the shape of a beak.
Salute. I require medicine.
Let me look. Someone your age cannot recover from a wound like this with medicine. Here is something to dull the pain. You will heal over time.
Grazie.
4 out of 5 doctors would suggest leeches, but they have not proven effective against such things. However, I can recommend several good colleagues around the city. Do you need anything else?
There we go. Now we can run and climb and jump.
Someone my age. Imbecile.
Well, considering you're, 41, 42 at this point, and considering when most people died of old age or infection back then, yeah, someone your age probably shouldn't be climbing around. Trinità de Monti. Best known for presiding over the Spanish steps which lead down to the Piazza di Spagna, construction of this church was completed in the early 1500s. Both the building and surrounding areas are property of the French state, who commissioned the project in celebration of their successful invasion of Naples. A very short-lived victory.
My back.
And right over here would be one of 10 feathers, but I have already gotten it. And once again, synchronize with the viewpoint, synchronize. Look at the map, synchronize with the viewpoint, synchronize. Jump into a haystack.
Word has gone out that a peasant is resisting arrest. We will show him how things operate under the Borgia.
Machiavelli can wait.
Change of plans, everybody. Let's tail some guards.
I have to sell our house, you know. There is nothing left to do. They demand more than I can give. A compensation.
curious what you
want. You don't see me.
Do you know what that pig-faced guard does?
Ow.
Most impressive. That is still being the guard.
Piazza di Spagna, future site of the famously peculiar Piazza di Spagna. This public expanse at the foot of the Spanish Steps is shaped as an elongated triangle rather than a square. Named after the Spanish embassy to the Holy See, the Piazza became one of Rome's most popular meeting places. Notably, the romantic poet John Keats spent his final hours in a flat overlooking the Piazza. A thing of beauty is a joy forever, except when you're about to die of tuberculosis. That stinks. Just gotta follow these guards. Just gotta follow these guards. Just gotta follow them, just gotta follow them, just gotta follow these guards.
I dreamt I was surrounded by sheep.
You dreamt you were surrounded by sheep? That probably means that you want to have sex with sheep. I hope it doesn't. Sometimes dreams are just nonsense. I think we're almost there. Just around this corner. Yep, here we go. Now to kill. Defend the man. But first, Piazza del Popolo. The future site of the famous Piazza del Popolo. In the early 15th century, the Piazza was merely the continuation of the Via Flaminia. As a result, it was most travelers' first view of Rome upon arrival. The powers that be eventually decided they'd rather the first impression of Rome be a little more expressive than a muddy expanse. So they set about building the beautiful square it is today. There's a one. There's a two. Nope. There we go. Full synchronization. One down. On to number two. I like this outfit.
Beautiful.
She was, until that porco defiled her. I wish he'd just killed her. I wish he'd just killed la mia amata. People who saw her grow up cheered when he spat on her. smiles on their faces when her neck...
I understand.
How can you? My Livia was innocent!
I have lost family to the rope. To treachery.
Il Carnefice watches from his home on the hill above. He threatens to hang me if I cut her rope.
When you are ready, take her down. I will deal with Il Carnefice.
And here we're introduced to the first Templar agent, which is one of the multiplayer people. Il Carnefice, born in 1473, executioner. There's nothing in the history books about Il Carnefice, so I did a little digging in Abstergo's mainframe. Here's what I found. A natural ally for the Borgia, Il Carnefice kills to the roar of an approving crowd. The other small piece of information I could dig up is that he fancies himself as some sort of twisted artist. I guess that explains the crowd bit. I wonder if he does tricks while performing executions, or whether it's all in the subtle way he pulls the lever. Well, either way, we're gonna kill him. Let's go this way instead. And use the lift. Whee!
Nice work down there.
Not my best. But it's hard to make art with poor materials.
How's this for art? My art is a stab in the face.
Requiescat in pace.
In another life, I would have said art is an explosion. Brownie points, if you know that reference.
Strike!
Nope. There's a one. There's a two. There's a three. There's a four. There's a five.
See you in hell. Won't get away with this.
I think I just did. Now for number three. Then we'll be all caught up.
You should spend more time in God's house.
Ezio, what a surprise to see you here.
I thought you had sent for me.
Never. News of the villa attack has spread across the city. We were certain that you were dead.
Not yet. I am still very much alive.
The Borgia must not discover that you escaped them. Follow me. Take care not to draw any undue attention.
When do I...
Mausoleo di Augusto. If you were anyone of importance in Rome and died between 24 BCE and 98 CE, you were buried in here. Occupied by the Colonna family in the Middle Ages, the mausoleo was fortified and converted into part of the Castel Sant'Angelo. Yes, they lived with dead people. After the humiliating defeat of the Commune of Rome in 1167, the Colonna family were disgraced, banished from the city, and their fortification was dismantled. Later, the family was allowed back in Rome and spent the duration of the Renaissance feuding with the rival Orsini family. If this teaches us anything, is that if you want to get rid of someone, hang them, because banishment is far too temporary. What's up, Niccolo? So yeah, the villa was attacked. People died. Like Mario. How's your day been?
You would be wise to purchase missing equipment. You will not live long in Roma without supplies.
I have my blade.
And the guards have their guns, courtesy of the Borgia. Fortunately, I can help you.
Grazie.
While you're in my debt, perhaps you will listen to reason.
As soon as I hear some, I will let you know.
Can you teach me to phase through objects like you did with that horse? Every Renaissance community needed a blacksmith. Swords, locks, pans, knives, nails, and armor were all made from metal, and all needed to be shaped. In addition, architectural ironwork flourished during the Renaissance as blacksmiths began to apply their practical craft toward making art.
As good as any you'll find, I...
Okay, let me buy some stuff. First, a stiletto. I already have it. Next, some armor. I already have it. Because I'm replaying this.
Please come again.
Bene. Now you can survive the journey back to Firenze.
Perhaps. But I'm not going to Firenze.
Oh.
There will be no peace until we rise up against the entire Borgia family and the Templars who serve them.
I do not recall such brave talk at Monteriggioni.
How could I have known that they would find me so quickly? That they would kill Mario?
Rodrigo surrounds himself with snakes and murderers. Even his daughter Lucrezia has been sharpened into one of his most artful weapons. But she pales in comparison to the man behind the villa attack. He is ambitious, ruthless, and cruel beyond imagining. The laws of men mean nothing to him. He murdered his own brother to take power. He knows neither danger nor fatigue. Those who do not fall by his sword clamor to join his ranks. The powerful Orsini and Colonna families have been brought to kneel at his feet, and the King of France stands at his side.
Give me his name.
Cesare. Head of the papal armies. What does he intend to do with his power? What drives the man? That I still do not know. But Ezio, Cesare has set his sights on all of Italia, and at this rate he will have it.
Is that admiration I hear in your voice?
He knows how to exercise his will. A rare virtue in the world today.
Well, that's nice to know. Seriously, how do you fade through objects? Teach me. Or not.
Should we not travel by horse? Roma is quite large.
As Cesare's conquests in Romagna continue to succeed, and the Borgia grow in power, they have taken desirable areas of the city for themselves. We cannot use the stables here.
Oh, the will of the Borgia is law now?
What are you implying, Ezio?
Do not play dumb with me, Machiavelli.
Do you have some kind of plan?
I am improvising.
We gotta kill a captain! Hi there!
So, you want it means to be an enemy of the Borgia! Come on, men! We are Borgia!
There! Kill the captain, they'll all flee in terror. I killed some people!
Just because you kill a few guards does not mean the people will grant access to the stables.
You are right. We need to send a signal. Wait here.
Okay, my work isn't done. Let's burn the tower down.
It seems the stable is now available for purchase.
After you.
And there we go. Now we are all caught up with where I was before. And that took about 26 minutes. Not bad. How about we go do one more and just end it with that? Time to buy the stables for 0 florins. That's a steal. Ta-da! Good as new. Don't lose any health. Let's go, Eagle. Nice music. Excuse us. The Pantheon. Oh yeah, and it has a cluster. That's one thing that got skipped over. Sean explaining that there are clusters in here. Anyway, the Pantheon. This architectural wonder still stands as the world's largest unreinforced concrete dome 2,000 years after it being built. The opening at the dome center, known as an oculus, is the singular source of light for the immense chamber. Constructed in 126 CE by Marcus Agrippa as the temple to all the ancient Roman gods, the Pantheon has since become a beacon of Christianity. The structure has been burned, rebuilt, robbed, modified, torn down, and renovated so many times the interior contains a myriad of conflicting icons and symbols. Apparently, most gods had their building constructed in their honor. I, however, recommend worshipping at the modern-day espresso bars surrounding it.
You excel at opening wounds, Ezio. But can you also close them?
I intend to heal the sickness, or treat its symptoms.
Stop sparring with me.
Fine. Let us talk openly then. Rodrigo Borgia's death would not have solved anything.
I am inclined to disagree.
Look at this city. The center of Borgia and Templar rule. Killing one man...
Oh no. Please don't. Oh my gosh. I think my game froze. I think it crashed. Well, that's one way to end the video, I guess. Well, guess we're ending it here. If you liked this video, let me know in the comments. If you really liked it, press that cute little like button. Thanks for watching, everybody. I'm Luke Dog, and I'll see you next time. What an awkward way to end it.